Hey everyone, it's Darren. Welcome. Today's video, we're going to talk about something called the sanity check. Sanity checks are the very first line of defense against bad data. You will use it in a bunch of different ways, but overall, what a sanity check is when you look at your data, does it look right or not? Does it look like there's something wrong? Sanity check is definitely never the last test for your data. It's never the last test for new programming, new functions, anything like that. But it is your first check. And I was first introduced to these, actually, in my first programming classes, where you're putting in formulas that maybe you do, maybe you don't know what the formulas are actually trying to accomplish. But you see, does this sort of thing make sense? Does it make sense that I've just come out to a total car weight of 150,000 pounds after I loaded 10 pounds of groceries into a 2,000 pound car? Probably a problem with the formula. And that's kind of what the sanity checks are designed to catch. It can catch some data entry errors, it can catch some unit errors, conversion errors, things like that. So a sanity check is never actually your last test for data. It is usually going to be your first test. It'll be the first thing you do when you put in new formulas in Excel or in database programs or really any kind of computer system, to make sure the formulas are actually doing what you're expecting them to do. And it'll also be a good first test just to quickly scan your data when you have data coming in to make sure that your data actually makes sense. So let's take a look at a couple of examples here. So up here on the screen, I have just some numbers assigned to people. This is for a class we asked students to keep track of how much time they spent on their homework the night before. And they came back, and Mary spent 45 minutes, and John spent 75 minutes, and Tony spent 20 minutes. And everything looks good, so we get down to Bill, who spent a half a minute. This one, probably there's something going on here. And in this case, with a sanity check, given the other numbers, we might be tempted to change that to 30 minutes. We can look at that. We know Bill didn't spend a half a minute working on his homework. You know, he might have spent zero time working on it, but we know he didn't spend a half a minute. So that brings up an important topic when you're working with sanity checks and with data in general. And we'll do a separate video on this later. When can you legitimately change the data? When can you legitimately say, this is bad data, and delete it? In this case, if I'm the teacher and I'm trying to figure out how long people are spending on homework, I'm comfortable changing this. This is just something that I need for me to keep track of what's going on. So I'm just going to go ahead and change that to 30 minutes because I know that's what Bill spent. I know he didn't spend a half a minute. So that's an example where probably okay for me to change this. If you're turning this in, if you're the teacher and you have to turn this into your principal, for example, then you might want to include a note that you changed it. Your principal will look at that and say, yeah, I know Bill didn't spend a half a minute. So yeah, that's fine. So let's look at another example though. Here's the number of cars entering a parking lot every hour throughout the day. And you know, we have 5 cars, 7 cars, 12 cars, 25 cars, picks up around lunchtime. At 2 o'clock, we had 0.7 cars entering the parking lot. We didn't have 0.7 cars entering the parking lot at 2 o'clock. Cars come in whole numbers only. You look at that, you can't really tell what it is. You know, unlike the homework time example, there's no real good way to tell what is that 0.7. It's obviously an error, but we don't really know what that error is. And we may have to go to the person who collected the data and ask them what that is. We may have to look at however the data is actually coming into us to figure out what that is. But we know that it's not 0.7. Do we just delete the data? Well, it looks like it's kind of a busy time. You know, the hour before it, at 1 o'clock, we had 25 cars. The hour after it, at 3 o'clock, we had 12 cars, so we'd expect this would likely be somewhere between 12 and 25, so it's not like it's even 7, probably. So there's an example where the sanity check detects a problem, but there's no way to tell what to do to fix it. Let's look at another example here. Here we have some sales figures for five of our salespeople, and it looks like Nancy is just not doing so great. So all the others are 120, 130, 140, $150,000, and Nancy has 3,500 bucks. And now you might just think Nancy had a really rough month here, and maybe she did. But what if Nancy's our best salesperson? And you just know that's not right. So that's another example where there's not an obvious problem, there's not an obvious solution to what's wrong with it. But you kind of know there's a problem. You know that the data just doesn't look right. It's possible that is right. It's possible Nancy was off on vacation for a few weeks or something. It's possible she's been putting all of her time into a big contract, and the next month she's going to come back with a $1 million contract. But the sanity check says, let's go take a look at this. Let's see what's going on if we can. Okay, one more case where we have sanity checks is when we're typing in formulas. Formulas, functions, programs, anything like that. And this doesn't apply just to Excel. Obviously, this is everywhere. This is if you're putting data into a database, it's if you're working on a program in C++ or Java or anything. You always want to make sure that your formulas are right. Now, here I have a spreadsheet, and I want to convert from Fahrenheit to Celsius. We've all done this a million times in school, right? And the formula is equals Fahrenheit, which is A2, times 9 divided by 5 plus 32, right? Okay. So we'll just copy this down. And I see 6,500 degrees Fahrenheit, 1,100 Celsius, whatever. Uh-oh, I recognize 75 Fahrenheit. That's a number that I'm familiar with. That's a comfortable summer day. It's not 167 degrees Celsius. So there's a problem here, and that's where I didn't verify the formula actually is correct, but I know this formula is wrong. I know that 75 degrees Celsius is not 167 degrees. Or 175 degrees Fahrenheit is not 167 degrees Celsius. And anyone who's familiar with this formula knows that you subtract 32 and then multiply by 5/9. And but this is another example where just looking at this, you can tell it's wrong, even though you might be completely confident with your formula. It could have just been a typo if I had done the right formula, but added 32 instead of subtracting 32 at the end, you would get something like this. The correct formula, if you're wondering, is actually it would be equals A2 minus 32 times 5 divided by 9, which comes up with the correct numbers this time. But it's very easy just to type in a formula wrong. If you did plus 32 instead of minus 32, and that's where sanity checks can sometimes find those things for you much quicker than actually going through, especially with complex calculations. So that's about all I have for you today for sanity checks. Always do them. If numbers look wrong, stop and figure out what's going on if you can. And sometimes, like in the case of the homework time, it's going to be pretty easy to figure out what's going on. You'll be able to fix it pretty quickly. In some cases, like the cars here, very obviously an error, but you have no idea why. You may have to figure out why if you can. In other cases, like the sales numbers here, probably an error. It looks wrong to me, but it might be right. It's just something you have to go look at. Always, if a number just really looks bad, sanity check says go verify it. We have some future videos we'll be doing that will get into how to determine whether the data is actually right, also what to do when your data is actually wrong, and how to manage that. If you learned something from this today, if you did, be sure to hit the like button. Also subscribe so you can be notified when new videos come out. I also have a Patreon page at patreon.com/dataanalysisexcellence. If you could help out the channel that way, that would be great. And have a great day.